Hello everyone, welcome to this session on strategic literature searching. My name is Helen Gibson, I'm a subject librarian for creative media, arts and design. Kelly Rogerson is the business and government subject librarian. We will be discussing strategic literature searching in three videos. This is what we will cover. In video one, we will be looking at topic and question analysis and then developing a search strategy. Video 2 will cover accessing databases, conducting an efficient literature search in databases, and advanced techniques in database searching. Video 3 covers non-database searching and other library resources, which is grey literature, conferences, reports, and citation searching. We will also let you know how to find help and support after this session. These are the steps to have efficient literature searching. Firstly, you need to understand, analyse, define and describe the topic. Then identify concepts, keywords and their synonyms. Determine the relationships between the concepts. This is using Boolean operators and or not. Combine the keywords and synonyms to create a strategy using appropriate resources, and then review and evaluate your results and steps. It is good practice to keep a research diary. Here are some useful tips before you begin your research. Keep a record of your search terms and also your search string and search filters, also the databases you have searched and the date that you have searched. This way, when you come back to repeat the search, you will follow exactly the same steps. The first step is to understand and develop your question. These are all the points that should be considered in clearly defining the parameters of your research topic. For your topic to develop, there must be a context. When placing your topic in context, it is often useful to think about the following. What is the scope of your research topic? What are the relevant related disciplines? Who is the intended audience? What is the purpose of the research? What is the time period? And also, what is the geographical coverage? Once you have defined and formulated your topic, the next step is to analyse your topic in more detail. To search the literature, you will need to describe your topic in broad and narrow concepts, determine keywords and phrases, consider synonyms and alternative terms, consider scientific and common terms, consider variations in spelling and plurals, decide if you should use controlled vocabulary, which are subject headings, as well as natural language. Here is a sample topic. Are school-based programs effective in reducing the high-risk behaviour of Australian teenagers? This is a brief description of your topic. Then you need to pick out and identify the main concepts of your research topics, and this can be words or phrases. It's a good idea to circle these or just to write them out separately. So the concepts for this topic are school-based programs, high-risk behaviour, and then teenagers and Australia. Once you have worked out the concepts, you need to identify keywords and synonyms you can use to search for these. So for school-based programs, synonyms are school and education. High-risk behaviour, synonyms for this term could just be high-risk, risk-taking or risky. And for teenagers, alternative terms or additional terms are adolescents, juveniles, teens, youth. This is a logic grid and it can be really useful in assisting you in defining and keeping a record of your topic. This grid is available at the link at the bottom right hand side of the screen. In the grid you can write out your topic, two lines, the research topic, then list your concepts across the top or search words taken from your topic. Then below each concept, list synonyms or alternative words. And there is also space for writing subject headings if you decide to use controlled language. Once you have clearly defined and analysed your topic, you can then develop a detailed search strategy. using the terms and combining the terms. The search strategy identifies the key concepts in a topic and the relationships between them. When creating a search strategy, you analyse and define your topic, identify the keywords, then brainstorm synonyms, and you can check these also with your supervisor, helping you define your topic. You need to be aware of plural forms and American spelling or alternative spellings. Combine keywords and synonyms into a search statement, and then review, evaluate results and modify where necessary. Once you have clearly defined and analysed your topic, you can then develop a detailed search strategy using the terms and combining the terms. A search strategy identifies the key concepts in the topic and the relationship between them. When creating a search strategy, analyse and define your topic, identify the keywords and concepts, brainstorm synonyms, be aware of plural forms and American spelling and alternative spellings. You then combine keywords and synonyms into a search statement. And finally, review and evaluate results and modify where necessary. To combine your search terms, you need to use Boolean operators. Boolean operators are combining words, and the three main operators are and, or, not. Using and narrows your search. Example, apples and oranges. This means that all of your results must have both terms in them, both apples and oranges. Using or broadens your search, so your results can have either of these terms or any of these terms, but it doesn't have to have all of them. Not. Using not excludes a term from your results. You need to be careful when using not, because sometimes you can exclude useful results. Here are some additional options to be considered. When you're searching for phrases of more than two words, you need to use quotation marks. This will look for words as a phrase in that order. So here are some examples: One River Colony, social media, and community development. Truncation, the most common truncation symbol is the asterisk, and by adding this to a word, it will look for variations of that word, for plurals, nouns, etc. Examples are model with an asterisk, and that will retrieve model, models, modelling, different spellings, and modelled. And the same for imagra with an asterisk, and theatre, which is the two variations of that word. You need to use truncation carefully. If you truncate too soon, you'll retrieve some words that are not required. Wildcard. A wildcard is a question mark, and this is used in replacement of a single character. For example, the two spellings of organisation. If you put a question mark where the S or the Z is, it will look for both forms of that word. And the same for woman or women, if you add a question mark instead of the A or E. Here is a sample search strategy for the topic Facebook and spread of fake news. So for Facebook, you can use that term, but also think of synonyms. So social media, in quotation marks, we'll search that as a phrase, and also social networks. These are joined by using the Boolean operator OR, because any of those terms are okay. And then combine it and narrow or refine by using AND. And synonyms for fake news could be deception or misinformation. Truncate misinformation, it will pick up misinformed misinformation. This search is fairly simple and uses two terms. If this question had asked about the ethical dilemma of fake news, you could add ethic with an asterisk to search within the results. Here is a second example of a search strategy. The topic is to find information on the importance of sleep in terms of university students' academic performance. Firstly, identify the concepts. These are university, students, academic performance, and sleep. Then think of synonyms for each of these concepts. So synonyms for university are college and higher education, and put higher education in quotation marks as it is a phrase. Student You can shorten that with a truncation symbol, because that is a student or students. Synonyms for academic performance are examination or exams or assessment, and they are truncated. And then synonyms for sleep are rest and fatigue. Then similar terms are combined with or, and then refined or narrowed by using and. The reverse side of the logic grid can be used to write out and keep a record of your search strings. Once you have developed a search strategy, you are ready to start searching databases. Kelly is going to demonstrate this in the next video. There is also a link to a 3-minute video on tips for creating search strategies. It is available via this link at the bottom right-hand side of the screen. Direct link where you can ask the library for assistance or also book a consultation with your subject librarian. It is available from the help and support link on the top hand of the page. Many thanks for your attention today, and I hope this session has been useful. If you have any questions, please contact the library.